Hey everyone, Cole Karski here. I'm here to do a video of what I'm going to call Setup Sundays. And that's where I go through one of my favorite presentations and go from top to bottom, why I'm choosing it, and go through the gear. And if anyone knows me personally, I love tackle and gear. I'm a gear junkie. So I thought this would be a fun way to kind of go through some of that and talk it through. So first, I'm going to start with a more of a finesse panfish presentation, tungsten and a plastic. And this is when the fish are eating on bugs and hatches. This is when I like to portray this. And so what I'm gonna do is I'll start out with the rod, reel line, and then move into the bait. So my favorite rod to do this with is a Delabay pan sizzler. This one's 29 inches. And the reason I like this rod is it has a really sensitive tip. I can see those bites, I can see the up bites, I can see when it lets go, but you can get into the backbone of this rod and it's gonna handle that stray bass or stray pike you happen to catch or the slap crappies. And I have it paired with a 13 Fishing Black Betty Free Fall. I like this for the one hand application. It locks in after you release the trigger and it allows you to just be really finesse with the fish. And it's got a very smooth drag and very smooth to reel as well. And I have it with the cold band snaps. I like the cold snap outdoors bands. And I like these because I can feel the cork and I don't have to have tape around and have my hands on the tape. And the way I actually grip the rod is I'll pistol grip this and I'll put my finger right here, and I'm not actually even touching the band at all. So it is very sensitive, and I get all the feel I could ask for without having to put tape over the feet of the reel. And I've used all sorts of tape and just not been a fan. So these are what I go with. I'm a big fan of these. Now, as far as the lure, I just have on this is a 5mm tungsten and a 1.1 inch plastic. And it helps just with a little bit bigger size to see in the video. This one happens to be a Crazy Critter from Euro Tackle. I really like this plastic because it has a lot of appendages, so it moves a lot of water, and you can really get a good motion out of it too for the visual for them coming in to see it. And it is on a 5mm Slayer tungsten jig. If you have never fished with Slayer, you got to do yourself a favor and pick some of these up this year. The glow on them is insane. The hooks are sticky sharp. They are super strong. I'm going to drop a picture of a fish here. I caught this on a 4mm Slayer tungsten, pan fishing for crappies under a bobber. Hook was not bent out at all. Jig came out in perfect condition. That's a big fish. So I highly recommend the Slayer tungstens. They're awesome. Go check them out. I'm also going to drop a picture here of what they look like all glowed up. It's pretty incredible stuff. You won't be disappointed. As far as line for the presentation, I have this on 3-pound fluorocarbon. It is from Fishing Line. That's L-Y-N. I'm really, really impressed with this stuff. The fluorocarbon is very, very soft and pliable. Way softer than I expected. I've fished some fluoros before and they've been stiffened and not very pliable, so I was not too thrilled with spooling up a whole spool of it with fluoro, but I really wanted the invisibility factor. So I gave this a go after doing a lot of research and I am flat out impressed. You should check them out as well. They are awesome company right in Minnesota here, and they're very reasonably priced. So if you have any questions on any of the setup, let me know. This would be my standard jig in a plastic, tungsten plastic setup, crappies, bluegills, what have you. It's Cole Karski here. Tight lines, everyone.